7:50 at KNEB. Time for News Extra, brought to you by Gehring Civic Center. And I'm Dennis Ernest. Two guests with us this morning, Jill Allen with the Volunteer Center and Sam Serda with the Panhandle Auto Group. And both here to talk to us this morning about the Snow Angel program. And Jill, give us a little background on Snow Angel program.
Sure. Dennis, thank you for having us this morning. So the Snow Angel program, we started 8 years ago. And the reason that we started this, Regional West partners with us for our Meals on Wheels program. And we noticed that, you know, once when we do have to cancel, unfortunately, the delivery of Meals on Wheels, and that's so hard on our recipients, and we have to do that. But at the same time, we don't want our volunteers getting stuck, and that has happened before. So once when we do have to cancel, and additionally, a few on the program, they have a hard time getting through the weekend because we don't deliver on the weekend. And so this just kind of helps ensure that there are food in their homes if we do have to cancel. And so we've done this for 8 years, and it's been a successful for us, actually. And the community really gets behind us and helps donate for this event. And so the things that we look for is non-perishable food items that are very easy, you know, good shelf life, and they're very easy to fix. So those items,
you may not have electricity. I mean,
if it's a big storm
that has stopped you from delivering meals, they may not even be able to microwave it, right?
Really, that's correct. And you know, last year, that storm, even though the main streets were clean, some of the side streets weren't, and it was still very hard to deliver. We had to cancel a few days, and then the third day when we go out, we had drivers stuck. So it's just one of those things. So anyways, the items that we are looking to collect, though, are peanut butter and jelly, tuna and crackers, canned soup, Jell-O packs, pudding packs, noodle packs, just stuff that's very easy to make and good shelf life. And so that's what we're looking for donation-wise.
Okay. Do you have a central location, or are you going to have?
Well, we have several, and we still have options if anyone wants to sponsor a box, if a business does. And if a business sponsors a box, how that works is they encourage their clients and employees to help fill the box. And, of course, then we promote that they're helping us. So this year, our sponsors are KNEB, Panhandle Auto Group, which is who Sam's with, who he'll get to talk in a second. Meridian Trust, Monument Chiropractic, which is a new one for us this year, as well as Riddles and Monument Mall. They're new partners. Main Street Market, First State Bank, Classic One Insurance, Regional West, Vertex, and of course you can drop them off at the Volunteer Center as well, which is at 1517 Broadway in Scotts Bluff.
In the Bluffs Business Center.
Yes, in the Bluffs Business Center.
Yeah. So again, you can make these donations with the food items right there.
Yes.
Can you write a check to the Volunteer Center?
And a lot of people choose to do that if you don't have time to go get the items or it's difficult to haul them. Of course, we use them all. They're all earmarked for the Snow Angel program, and then we fill in the gaps of what we didn't get enough of. A lot of times we're short of peanut butter and jelly, so that is one thing that we usually have to go buy. So that helps us fill in those gaps.
Okay. So how long do you do this? How long is the
collection? Our official kickoff is October 20th, and then we go for an entire month. So it'll go through November 20th.
Okay.
And then we'll utilize a lot of volunteers to help sort those items and stuff the bags, and then we'll go out for delivery.
Okay. That's a big project.
It really is.
All right. We're going to talk to Sam and find out more in just a moment. Stay right there.
It's the Civic Center's 24th annual Holiday Craft Fair and Specialty Foods Expo with handmade crafts of gourd art, Americana, clothing, and many holiday items. Taste and buy gourmet foods, including artisan breads, honey, ethnic foods, gourmet caramel apples, and more. Shop early Friday night, November 3rd, from 5:30 to 8, and Saturday, November 4th, from 9 to 4 at the Gehring Civic Center's Holiday Craft Fair.
On News Extra, we're visiting about the Volunteer Center and the Snow Angel program, which will kick off Thursday.
Friday. Yep.
Good Lord, I should know what Friday is. All right, Friday the 20th, and it will run for a month, so you can drop off those food items. Now, your partner here this morning, Sam Serda, Panhandle Auto Group. Sam, how you doing?
I'm doing good.
All right. Tell us what's going on, how you're partnering with this, and how you're a part of this.
Well, I normally try to help Jill out every year, and this gal works pretty hard, so we thought we'd give her a little boost here. And what we're going to do is, she always says that the peanut butter and jellies are hard to come by. And so at Panhandle Auto, we're going to give away $100 to whoever brings in the most peanut butter and jelly. We'll be doing an open house on Friday, October 27th, and Saturday, October 28th, from 11 to 1, both days. And we're going to do a free will meal donation. Anytime somebody comes in and grabs a meal and donates a little money, that money will go back to the organization.
All right, very good. So Panhandle Auto Group there on East 20th, right?
Correct. 1906 East 20th Place.
Yep, where Husker Auto used to be, if that's more familiar.
That is more familiar, correct.
Yeah. All right, so you're there, and you're going to have this open house then the 2 days of next weekend?
The 27th, 28th.
Mm-hmm. All right, so folks can come by and make a donation, and you'll turn that into peanut butter and jelly for Food Angels.
That is right.
Very cool.
And if they bring, and what we're doing with the $100, if they bring, whoever brings the most peanut butter and jelly, they will get $100. That's right, so what
bring,
they're donating.
Yes. So bring the Jif with you.
That's right. You can bring the Jif or
Peter Pan or House matter. Brand or whatever it is. Doesn't matter.
We're thankful for any of it. So
absolutely. All right. Very good. Well, tell us a little more about Volunteer Center. I know you have a lot of projects that go on there all the time. Kind of beneath the surface, if
yeah,
you will.
Yeah, sure.
Meals on Wheels is one of them, but what else do you do?
Yeah, Meals on Wheels. We do the Shopping for Senior program. We partner with Main Street Market on that. We grocery shop for homebound individuals in our community in Scottsbluff and Gearing. And we call about 85 people a week to see if they need groceries. And if they do, we write it down, shop for it, and then Main Street Market delivers those. And we partner with Capwin for home-delivered commodities, and that's us bringing it's about a 30-pound box of food to individuals that qualify, 60 and over, low income.
How often does that happen?
That is the third Wednesday of the month.
So that's a monthly deal.
Yep, that's a monthly deal. And, of course, we have our big food drive, the Snow Angel Food Drive. We partner with you guys for Thanksgiving in the Valley. We do the delivery of the meals, which ends up being about over 400. And then, additionally, we help other nonprofits find volunteers, and we also help individuals in our community finding volunteer opportunities, not just through us, but through other agencies in the community.
So kind of a volunteer clearinghouse in a way.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Help people out. Well, it's amazing. I don't know the logistics of all those things that you do. Mapping routes for Thanksgiving alone is nuts, but you have all these kind of things that you're always mapping out deliveries and then packaging things and getting it all set. It takes a lot of hands.
It does. We utilize a lot of volunteers. Even the Meals on Wheels program alone, we utilize 115 a month to make that happen. So, and Regional West is a great partner with us for that. They make great meals for the clients, and we utilize volunteers to take them out, and it's a great thing, and the volunteers love it. I have tons of volunteers this year that have hit year 16. They've helped for 16 years. Mm. Weekly. I mean, it's a good program.
And then some can be hit and miss, right? I mean, you don't have to say, I'm going to do this for the next 16 years.
Oh, absolutely not. I don't want to deter anybody. Absolutely not. Even if people would be on a sub list, you know, and I can call them if something happens that morning and I have no one to help me drive. Because sometimes I'm sitting there and something happens and I'm sitting there with two routes, you know. So it's good if I can find just people that would be subs and people that would drive during the Snow Angel time. You know, I have drivers that help all year, but if they have little cars or they're just scared to drive on some of that worse weather, just people that would be on a sub list for that.
Yeah. And what would it take normally for a person to do it on a given day?
Okay, so normally it takes our drivers about an hour. Now, again, if you're unfamiliar with the addresses, it will take you a little bit longer. But especially if you're a little familiar with it, and it's enjoyable. The recipients enjoy receiving the meal, and that's not just that well-balanced meal that's good for them. It's also, it's a well check. If something's wrong, they can call for help. It's socialization. A lot of individuals, they just don't have anyone in their lives anymore. So it's a friendly face at the door. And
might be the only face they see for another
for
week.
Days. Yeah. Exactly.
Yeah. So it's a great program. So, starting next week, give us get the hit and miss here of the...
So Friday we actually kick off the Snow Angel Food Drive, so we'll distribute all the Snow Angel boxes, all the businesses that are sponsors. They will have a box with angel wings, so if you see that somewhere, that's our boxes.
Absolutely.
Yeah, and so that kicks off the 20th. Of course, Sam, what's happening with you again?
Reminder. We're going to give the $100 away for anybody who brings in the most peanut butter and jelly, and that will begin on the 20th also. And we'll be taking it. We'll be taking those donations as long as Jill wants me to, I guess.
Mm-hmm. Oh,
and then
awesome.
your open house on the following weekend, the 26th and 7th?
27th and 28th.
27th and 28th. Very good. Thanks for coming by and visiting with us
today.
Thank
you. Thank you for having us.